Excellencies, Honourable Ministers, Madam Executive Secretary of ESCAP, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. Excellencies, today we have come together to dialogue on progress that we are making to accelerate.
But the fact remains that remains the.
And of course, as a region that has inconsequential amounts of carbon emissions compared to the G7 countries, for example, it's important that we build resilience against the impacts of climate change. Looking at financing modalities such as borrowing to help us build resilience is not the way to go. All we're doing is adding debt to countries that have come out of COVID with increased debt. And to me, it is actually quite offensive that we would be required to borrow money to build resilience and to borrow from the very countries that are causing the effects of climate change.
This was a way that we needed to address the impacts on vulnerable countries.
Rather than the previous way of looking at it from a benevolent donor and a grateful recipient type of relationship, this is now more of a partnership arrangement based on mutual benefit. And again, this is important then that we do have a voice and a strong voice at that when we talk to G7 members.
Our coastal communities are being inundated by sea level rise. Ali, and I bring warm greetings from Palau.
Anytime we get to talk about Palau, we get to talk about the Pacific, we get to talk about...
One is they've talked about helping, right? Well, that help is few and difficult to get to. And it's almost like they say they want to help you, but they don't really want to help you. They want to make it difficult for you to get access to the financing. And then they can't even live up to the $100 billion commitment. But when it comes to spending money on military, they have no problem spending money on military, and lots of money. The $100 billion is kind of small compared to what they're spending on military expenditures.
To share a Palawan story about the Ubud brothers.
You know, they would have to honor their agreement. If they cut it, that means they're violating their own agreement. So I would hope that the United States honors their agreements. I would hope that they would raise their debt ceiling and honor their commitments to pay their bills. I don't know why we have to go through this pain for the United States and for the world watching this. I mean, I think we have to be realistic. We have to come up with solutions, and we should think positively.
Distinguished delegates, the 78th session of the Commission